My grandfather's clock was too large for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was larger by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny ounce more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born, and was always his treasure and pride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. In watching its pendulum swing to and fro, many hours he had spent when a boy. And in childhood and manhood the clock seemed to know and to share both his sorrows and joys. Life seconds numbering, tick tock, tick tock. It stopped short, never to go.